better and want to go? Now, come on now. Now, not to worry. The Black Hawk has a sophisticated anti-icing and de-icing system. You see, it's so sophisticated, I can't describe the system. But here's what you need to know. In order for the anti-icing to prevent ice and the de-icing to shed ice systems to work on a Black Hawk helicopter, I need two out of the two engines at full operational power. Very, very, very important. How many engines do I need?
Two
engines at full operational power. We get ready to go. Derek, I'm in the right seat. I am the co-pilot, Chief Warrant Officer 2 at the time. And in the left seat is Derek. Derek is the pilot in command. He is also a Chief Warrant Officer 2. We're the same rank, but he is a Chief Pilot in Command status. I have not. Behind us are 2 crew chiefs. Behind the crew chiefs, now in helicopters, it's not like airplanes. There's no center aisle. The seats go all the way across from the door to the door. If you want to change seats, you've got to get out of the helicopter. So the seats go all the way, I'll come up for it more so y'all can see. So the seats go all the way across. So, and then behind that row of seats is another row of seats, and they're back to back, so the seat backs attached to each other. And then behind that row of seats, all the way in the back along the bulkhead wall, is another row of seats. And sitting in that very back row is a colonel from our brigade. We're down here at the platoon. Platoon, company, battalion, brigade. He's 4 levels up the chain. We don't know him, but he is our liaison to the governor. Now let me ask you this. Who's in charge? Are you sure? All right, it's a trick question. When we're in the air, who's in charge? Let's get really, really clear. It's not me. It is the pilot in command in charge. I'm the co-pilot. The pilot in command is in charge when we're in the air. When we're on the ground, though, who's in charge? The colonel, the liaison to the governor, is in charge. Got it? Say got it if you got it.
Got it.
All right. So we get ready to go. Tricky mission, real mission, people are dying, we gotta go. So we get ready, and Derek decides I'm gonna fly the helicopter, and he's gonna navigate and talk to air traffic control. So I'm on the controls flying, and we come up to a hover. Let me just insert in here. I am really good at hovering now. We come up to a hover, everything looks good. We have our fuel for the mission, our power, all the systems are in good shape. Everything looks good. We have our clearance from air traffic control, and I pull more power, the tail kicks out, the feet come back. All white. You can't see anything. It's like being on the inside of a cotton ball. Except I do see something. Ice building on the windshield right in front of my eyes and all around the metal surfaces of the edges. Ice layer upon layer going thicker and thicker right in front of my eyes. I have to tell you, the pucker factor was high. But you know how it is when you're stressed? How many of you have ever been in a stressful situation? Yeah, the longer you're stressed, the more used to it you get, right? Does it become a new normal for you? Yeah. And so about 15 minutes into the flight, I start relaxing a little bit because I'm getting used to the ice and everything's performing good and we're doing okay. So I start relaxing a little bit, and that's when I hear something. Master caution alarm. Oh, shoot. How do you think that's what you really said? There's some younger girls in the room, so we'll just leave it there. Master caution alarm. I'm on the controls. Sometimes when something goes wrong in a helicopter, you can feel it, kind of like when something goes wrong with your car. Do you get like a shimmy, a shake, a thud, a thump, a sound, some kind of indication something is wrong? I'm flying on the controls and everything is responding normally. So I start communicating to my pilot in command. Derek, we have a master caution alarm, but we're maintaining our altitude and our airspeed and everything looks okay. And I turn and look at Eric, and here's Eric in the left seat. Oh my gosh, 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 You ever have those moments where you think, they're not gonna help you much? And you realize you're gonna have to pick up a little bit of their weight. So I'm on the controls flying, And I start scanning the instruments. We have to troubleshoot, find out what's wrong. And I see it, one gauge in the middle, up and down, up and down, up and down, up and down. RPMs on engine number two. We're in the clouds, in the icing. How many engines do I need?
Two.
If one's going up and down, how many do I really have?
One.
Is this good?
No.
This is bad. So I'm on the controls flying. I turn and look at Derek. Derek, we have fluctuating RPM on engine number two. Here's Derek. Oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh. Fluctuating RPM on engine two. We need to take the engine offline. It was at that moment that I realized engine number two is over my head. Our helicopter's loud. Yeah, engine number two is over my head. I could hear the engine steady. You see, if the RPMs were truly fluctuating, it would sound something like this. As it spooled up, and then, oh. So it would sound like this. And it was a steady roar. So I instantly knew from all the extra studying I had to do as the only girl in the class that the raw data from the internet went into a computer. The computer put it into the gauge. We had a computer malfunction. The engine was fine. I turn and look at Derek. Derek, we have fluctuating RPM engine too, but I can hear the engine is steady. We have a computer chip malfunction. Do you think he heard me?
No.
Oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh. Fluctuating RPM engine two, we need to take the engine offline. Now, if that engine had truly been fluctuating, we would take it offline to prevent the other engine from chasing it and preventing both engines from overarcing. But we don't. And if Derek, who had put his hand on the throttle, if he pulls that engine off, we lose our anti-icing, de-icing capability. Ice would form on our lift surfaces and we would crash. At that time, the valuation of the helicopter was $18 million. We would crash an $18 million helicopter with a crew of four and a colonel on board. So let me ask you, what would you do? Y'all are violent. I'd hit him, I'd punch him, I heard somebody say. Somebody said I'd pull a gun. We didn't have any, it was peacetime. Here's the thing. You're on the controls flying. There's no autopilot, just like your life. You're on the controls. You're in the pilot seat. You're in the pilot command of your life. If you take your hands off the controls to worry about someone else, you create a whole new set of problems. You're on the pilot seat of your life. So here's what I did. I'm on the controls flying. I can't hit him. I'm on the controls, and here's what I did. Don't touch that throttle. You want to wait until we're out of the icing, out of the clouds. Be my guest. I can fly this helicopter on one engine, but not while we're in this icing. You will not pull this throttle back while I am flying the helicopter. Look it up in the book. Well, the operator's manual for the Black Hawk is 4 inches thick. It's really hard to get to in the front of the helicopter. He gets it out anyway. Now, I will tell you, in his defense, this had nothing to do with gender. I found out later this was his first emergency procedure as a pilot in command. He pulls out the book, he starts flipping through the pages to find the emergency procedure I already knew. I already had memorized. And I just keep flying. And we get out of the icing, out of the clouds. We can safely fly on that one engine now, and I'm waiting for it. Silence. Nothing. And I just keep flying. And then as we go into final approach to Albany, New York, Derek clicks the intercom on and says, "Crew chief, please write up this aircraft for signal data converter computer chip malfunction." My response, "What a good idea. I am so glad you thought of that." And we land. We get the part in and we start flying missions. And the colonel, who was in the back, he comes up to me. "Chief Mack, you're gonna go here, here, here." I pull out my notepad. "Yes, sir, yes, sir."